Dean Thomas here at the Tokyo 5 booth at the UFC MMA Expo, and I'm here with none other than Ricardo Cachajão. I hope I said that right. Cachajão Almeida. Man, what's going on? What are you doing here?
I'm here just signing for Tokyo 5.
Tokyo 5, huh?
Yeah.
Are they one of your prominent sponsors?
Yeah, they're one of my prime sponsors. I've been working with them for the past few fights, and they make some cool stuff, so here I am.
Man, now, you know, one thing that stands out about you when I think of you is that a couple of years ago, you had took some time off and you said that you wanted to retire from fighting. The next thing I know, you came back, and you didn't only come back, you came back with a vengeance, man. Tell us a little bit about the reason why you came back and what's going to move forward for you.
Yeah, you know, like fighting takes a toll on our body, you know? So I took 4 years off, I came back and, you know, I was fresh, I was, I really wanted to train hard. You know, sometimes we don't want to train and you're a little beat up, and I just came back a lot of energy, and I've been just like that ever since, you know?
Yeah, I tell you what, man, you came back and you've been busting cats up.
Yeah.
What's next for you? Any opponents waiting?
I'm fighting UFC 117, August 7th, I'm fighting Matt Hughes, you know? So I want to get a little redemption for the team. I still think that Matt Serra beat him, you know? They took that one away from us, but, you know, hopefully I'll get it.
You know, that's the one thing you gotta love about the UFC is they always like to try to keep the rivals together. It's like when one guy wins, the other guy wins. So what are your predictions for that fight? And then I'm gonna ask you another major prediction about tonight's fight.
If you're fighting
against Matt Hughes in a perfect scenario, what's gonna happen?
Submission for sure. You know, that's what I'm gonna be looking to do. He's tough to take down, but you know, I gotta scrap with him a little bit on the feet, get him to take shots from outside, hopefully catch him in the guillotine or something like that.
I like it, man. I like it. I hope he doesn't hear this, but I like it. But I tell you what, I mean, I'm talking to one of the best jiu-jitsu guys to ever fight in MMA. That's Ricardo Almeida. Now, as I said before, tonight's fight, the big fight, Rampage, Rashad, who's going to win and why?
You know, we talked about time off in a little while, but when guys take time off to go do movies and things like that, like, their focus is never the same. I'm a big fan of both guys, but I think that Rashad is probably going to win just because he's been doing this full time, whereas Rampage has been doing the 18, you know, like, it always takes the toll on your training.
How's he going to win?
Probably decision.
Okay, there you have it. Ricardo Almeida's pick. He's got Rashad. And for me, I'm thinking back of all the people I've asked today. And today, I think Rashad has overwhelmingly started to sweep the poll of who's going to win. No kidding. So once again, I'm Dean Thomas here with Ricardo Almeida at the Tokyo 5 booth at the UFC Fan Expo.
Hey, this is Ricardo Almeida. You're on the nextgreatfighter.com.